Hey, Bo, wait for a second. See sparks coming out.
In the dying days of the season, the Blacklighters need to urgently locate the source of sparks coming from their second-hand excavator.
Arcing out on there, maybe.
If it breaks down, they have no way of working the open-cut mine, their only chance of finding Opal.
See how that's gone? Has that always been gone?
Oh, hang on, they're touching.
Was the battery melting?
This was touching that.
Yep.
Cooking the battery.
That's what it is.
Yep.
We need to secure and mount the batteries.
Yeah. What's happened now is this battery slid back down. This terminal here was touching on the wire, shorting it out, dropping sparks through. It'll burn out all the lead on the terminals. Basically like an arc welder, really. Not good. Not good at all. Righto, so I'll put something in the middle there.
Yeah. Get some rocks. Get our rock.
Perfect size rock and just whacked it in there. That'll do for tonight. Tomorrow we'll get a proper setup for it and make sure it doesn't happen.
Righto, there's another night out the way.
Shut her down, mate.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Let's get to bed, eh?
Next morning, there's good news. Opalzilla's repairs are ahead of schedule.
Now we'll get back to Opalzilla, get it going.
Hopefully.
Hopefully. Home stretch for us. There you go, mate.
Yeah, good, mate. Just finishing up.
Oh, are you kidding me?
No.
Already?
All done. All done, son.
Oh, mate, you are an absolute legend, eh?
It's got the new end on it.
Oh, yeah. You are an absolute champ.
As good as the new one, mate.
What can't you do, eh? The drums turned out magnificent. Awesome job. Just can't believe it. Out in the middle of the desert, you can find such nice people that are willing to help you. It's great. Now we're going to go get Opalzilla going. That's the plan.
Summer temperatures reaching over 45 degrees will soon make Coober Pedy too hot to work. The area is also at risk from monsoonal storms that can flood mines and destroy equipment.
When we broke the shaft in Opalzilla, we had probably half to maybe three quarters of a bin full of dirt in there. We need that out. If we leave it in there and rains, it'll just set to almost like concrete and we'll be stuffed next time we come back. So it's got to be done no matter what.
Shoveling out the 3 tons of dirt inside Opalzilla by hand risks heat exhaustion. Their only option to shift it is a working conveyor belt.
Yeah, we've got our drum out here. We've got a chance to get all fixed up and back into action, but the belt's so tight that there's no room for us to just slide the drum in. It's not easy.
The 80-kilogram drum...
It's gonna fall.
..has to be positioned inside the rubber belt. Then the central shaft slid into narrow steel holders either side.
We might be able to slide it over one way and then just tap it back.
Push, Mark, hold it there. Just hold it.
Yep.
I need that slack of the belt to get it up.
Ooh. Yeah. Oh. Hang on.
That almost got nasty.
Oh, more towards town more?
Is that it?
No, nah, more. Need probably another inch, 2 inches. Keep going, keep going, keep going.
Is that it, Mark?
No, there's a bit. No, not much more, that's it.
Well, that's not going to work then. Have you got any more that side? Oh, no, the drum's actually on the frame there. Yeah, that's a bit of...
We tried, man. Too awkward. It's trial and error. Everything up here is trial and error, so stuff's gonna break. You've got to show strength when it does break and just fix it.
The Blacklighters need to get Opalzilla's conveyor belt running to clear out 3 tons of dirt from the bin before summer rain sets it like concrete.
We tried, man.
Plan A didn't work. We go back to plan B and, yeah, hopefully we'll be in soon.
Plan B means using the loader to wrench the 100-kilogram belt back so they have space to manoeuvre the drum into position.
It's quite a task. It's effing dangerous because you got Mark with the loader pulling so much pressure on that shaft. If something slips or breaks and we're standing right behind it, that hits you in the head, it'll kill you. So, yeah, it's not the best job to be doing, but we'll do what it takes to get it working.
The pole has got to go towards the loader.
Yeah, it's got to keep reefing it forward.
All right, I'll reef forward and these guys go up.
That's it, keep going.
That's close, man. Need that bit more.
There we go, we're in.
Righto, hold her there.
Yo, beauty!
Oh, I finally got it in there. Thank God for that.
Trouble.
With the drum fixed, yep. The Blacklighters can now empty Opalzilla and shut it down for the season.
Well done.
Well done, mate.
Woo.
Well done.
Yep, it's good, man.
There's just one day left, and the last chance of finding Opal means working into the night at their open-cut mine.
Yeah, fingers crossed we don't have too many more sparks flying out the back.
Hang on, Paul.
Hang on, Paul.
Oh!
Oh, shivers.
Hello.
Woo! That's chunky time.
Squizzy, is that?
Oh, golly gosh.
Under here too.
Oh, look at that. Buddy.
That's a jackhammer.
Yeah, jackhammer for that, man. Oh, yeah.
Right, I'll be back.
Comes Jackie. The excavator's a little bit rough, so we just don't want to break it, so we're just going to get the jackhammer out and take it out properly, so, yeah. Better to be safe than sorry. We don't want to break a nice piece in half.
The whole piece is moving, pop it out. Yep.
Oh, here we go. Fatty biscuits.
Fatty biscuits.
I just want to lick it.
Where's the bucket?
Where's the bucket, eh?
Beauty. There we go. Here we go, Journals. There he is. Hello.
That's chunky.
I found him.
Oh, here he is.
That's a total level, eh? That's gold. Starting to make a seam now running back that we're following, so pretty well a bit of a pocket. I don't want to say it, but yeah, it looks like we're on a bit of a pocket, eh? So, beauty.
That looks a bit chunky.
We're going to need a bigger bucket, man.
Oh, dear.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, dear.
Hello.
Jackhammer.
Oh, it's a big chunk. Looks like there's a bit of colour sitting on top of the matrix there. It actually looks quite good.
On the last evening of their mining season, the Blacklighters have finally hit Opal.
Oh, get that chunk in the bucket.
They're one step closer to realising their dream of working a successful open-cut mine.
It's got, like, the veins running through it like boulder.
Yeah,
it's matrix. The green, like, veins. Oh, here we go.
Got him.
Hello. That's a nice chunk. There's a biscuit.
Another biscuit.
Yeah, so we're starting to get there. There's a few nicer bits in there.
It's awesome to be filling the bucket. Seems our methods are paying off, so hopefully we can get some money in the bank at the end of the week. It'll be good.
Yeah, this is amazing. Beautiful night, spend with a couple of mates and finding something that you just don't often do. It's like, good as it gets, eh, really?
What's happening here, Mark?
What's going on here?
I've been going through the parcel, grading it out. See what we got. We've got our tops here from where we ripped the other night. There's some quite nice pieces.
Bit of blues, bit of greens, bit of crystals.
That's a bit pretty.
Yeah,
that's
a beautiful pipe in there, eh?
Stuck up in there.
Not too bad, eh? Like, that's a nice week's worth.
The Blacklighters have white and crystal opal. Blue-green in colour. It's in the rough. And there's 510 grams.
Some beautiful colour, eh?
Righto, well, what do you reckon it's worth, mate?
Well,
10 grand there, tell me there's 10.
Well, mate, we've got someone willing to pay 15 for the whole parcel now, so. Yep, I know.
Scored!
That's a win.
What a week, mate.
That's a good ending.
Yeah.
All right, well, I reckon last one in the pool buys a bottle.
Righto! Ah!
The Blacklighters' first season in Cooper Pedy has netted them a $189,000 haul.
It's nothing to be down and out about. I mean, we've still had a pretty damn good year.
We're in a way better position now than we were when we turned up, so I think we should be proud of that.
Feels to me that there's a lot of opal out there and we might end up rich next year.
We'll be back earlier, bigger and better than ever. Don't worry about that.